Good morning, dear students. Okay, where we have stopped in the last class, up to which concept? That is regarding the gravitational potential energy will be equal to that of change in potential energy equal to that of the work done by a body. Okay, so next concept is regarding the conservative force and the non-conservative force. You know the term work done. How we can define that term? Work done. Work done is the product of force and displacement. Or we can also define as it's the product of magnitude of component of the force along the direction of the displacement and also the magnitude of the displacement. Okay, let's see the term, that is conservative force and non-conservative force. Conservative and non-conservative force. Okay, in that first term, how we can define that term? Conservative. Conservative force. So, yavaga force anna conservative ide anta helthave. So, for example, okay, imagine just that this position indicates the college. The position college indicate ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು ಈ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯನ್ನ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು. ಓಕೆನಾ? ನಿಮ್ಮ ಈಗ ಸಪೋಸ್ ನೀವು ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಏನಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಕಾಲೇಜ್. ನೀವು ಫೈನಲ್ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು, ಫೈನಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಏನು? ಹೋಮ್ ಹೌದಾ? ಮನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್, ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಟು ಹೋಮ್ ಇನ್ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇಸ್. ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ದಾರಿ ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಹೌದಾ? ಬೇಗ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಇದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ? ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಿ. ಈಸಿಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಬೇಗ ಬೇಗ ರೀಚ್ ಆಗುವಂತ ದಾರಿ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಿ. ಹೌದಾ? ಇವತ್ತು ಪುರ್ಸತ್ತಿದ ಆರಾಮಾಗಿ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗುವ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಲೆಂದಿ ವೇ ಅನ್ನ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಿ. ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಐದರ್ ಫಾಲೋ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಪಾತ್, ಕರ್ವ್ ಪಾತ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಜಿಗ್ಜ್ಯಾಗ್ ಪಾತ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ರೀಚ್ ದ ಯುವರ್ ಹೋಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಫೈನಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್. ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಫೈನಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಈ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಂದ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು? ಸೊ ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಟಿವ್. ದ ಪಾತ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದಿ ಪಾತ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದಿ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೈನಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್. ಯಾವ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ? ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಫೈನಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಇರುವಂತದ್ದು. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೀ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್. ದಿ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಟಿವ್. Force is said to be conservative if the work done by the force does not depend upon path follow, but depends only on initial and final position. Okay, this is regarding the conservative force. Example, gravitational force. Okay, next term, electrostatic force. Next term, one more example, elastic force of a spring. Okay, next term, let's define the next term, that is, what's that? non-conservative force. Non-conservative force. Here, reverse of the conservative. Okay? In case of non-conservative, it does not depend upon the initial and final position. It depends upon only on the path power. We have path and power quantity. Other minus K and I wrote that though. Depend upon. Depend I wrote that. Work done. So short notation and I use my director. Don't talk to you about X part money. Work done by a force. Depends. Upon the path followed, not on the position, that is initial and final position. Okay, this is the definition of the non-conservative force. Some examples: frictional force. Frictional force. So frictional force will exist upon the when two bodies are in contact. Okay. If we clap your hands, okay, or clap your hands, such what happens here? Opposing force exists between the palms of your hand. So the force which exists is a frictional force. Okay. Next one, viscous force exists between the layers of the liquid. Next up, A, resistance. Okay, let's see the difference between the conservative force and the non-conservative force. Okay, let's see the difference between the conservative force and the non-conservative force. So here, in case of conservative force, first let's write the definition. Conservative force and non-conservative force. Okay. First point, work done by the force does not depend on the path followed. Work done by the force does not depend upon the path followed by the body. In this case, first point what we can write? Work done by the force depends on path followed. Depends on path followed. Depends on path followed. Okay. Next point. Work done in a round trip is zero. Work done is not zero in case of round trip. Because of what? Conservative force alone, and with the round trip one circular path hoga. So initial position minus final position, both initial position and final position will be same in case. So total work done will be what? Zero, isn't it? Okay. Next point, work done is completely recoverable here. Work done is not recoverable. Fourth point, when force acts on a body, okay, what kinetic energy and potential energy may vary, but sum of two remains constant. Okay. Next, whereas in case of non-conservative force, okay. So here, work done by the force is already not recoverable. So where the work done goes here, so work done by the force may shifted or dissipated into heat energy. Okay now? So these are some difference between the conservative force and the non-conservative force. Okay, let's see next concept. Okay, three most important item next regarding the conservation of mechanical energy. So energy, law of energy for the conservation, energy can be neither be created, okay, energy can be neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be transferred from the one form to another. So the mechanical energy definition says what? It's the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy gives the total mechanical energy, and that value always remains constant. So in case of conservative mechanical energy, the sum of kinetic energy plus potential energy will be constant. Okay. Next, law of conservation of total mechanical energy. Okay, so they may ask the law for 1 or 2 marks. Okay, and with the using this law concept, you have to illustrate an example of a freely falling body. You have to prove that at each and every position, the order may be the value of K and V. That is, order may be the value of potential energy and kinetic energy. Add up and add the total mechanical energy. Any rathe? Ado prathi ondu point alli kuda eni rathe? Same rathe anta prove madbeku. Okay, let's do that. Next, let's see the first statement first. What it states? The total mechanical energy of a system is conserved if the forces doing work on it is zero. In statement karte hain, so total mechanical energy conserved rehta hai andar rehta hai. The possibility of the forces doing work done by the force will be zero. Then only, so we can say total mechanical energy of the system is conserved. Okay. Let's see an illustration of a freely falling body. Okay, illustration of a
nothing but one example to do that this law. Okay, a really poly body. Okay, suppose if there is one ball, ನಿಮ್ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾಲ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಬಾಲ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿಡಿತೀರಿ. ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿಡಿದಾಗ ಏನು, ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಂದ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಹೈಟ್, ಸೇ ಎಚ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಲೀವ್ ದಟ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀಲಿ, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಲೀವ್ ದಟ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀಲಿ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಆಬ್ಸ್ಟಕಲ್. Okay, so consider a body or an object. Okay, consider an object whose mass is m. Okay, it is the ground level. Okay, the ground level namdu a body ide e portion alli ide. Let that point to be a. The height from the ground, let it be h. So, a portion in the height is there. Height h. Okay. Next, here, when I leave this object, it follows this path and finally reach the ground. So what is my main intention is that at each and every position the total energy is conserved. Okay, that value remains constant. So I consider three parts. It is point A, let this point be C. Okay, so here there is an object at point A. Okay, its mass is given by m. The height above the ground is h. Okay, so first point, at point A, what is the main condition here? Particle is at rest condition. Okay, particle or any object is in the rest condition. Okay, therefore if it is in the rest condition, what we can say kinetic energy is zero.